candidate, His Excellency Atiku Abubakar. Thank you. Dear citizens of Nigeria, let me start by thanking you all for choosing democracy as the settled system of government for our great nation. As you all know, democracy is a government of the people and by the people. Only when the people's choice prevails. That did not happen on Saturday, February 23, 2019. On election day, we saw the implementation of grand theft of the people's will. I am not one for hyperbole, so I will just let the facts speak for themselves. In Akwa Ibom, for instance, the results showed a statistical impossibility of a 62% drop in voter numbers from the 2015 elections, even where voter registration and PVC collection rates were much higher than in 2015. This is where voter suppression took place. And you must recall our party made this observation and complaint before the elections that there were plans to implement voter suppression on PDP or opposition strongholds and voter increase in APC strongholds. This pattern was repeated in strongholds of the People's Democratic Party, including in states like Delta, Rivers, Abia, and Benue states. And this was occurring. We saw another statistical impossibility, wherein voter turnout and numbers increased astronomically in Borno State by an almost miraculous 82% in the midst of insecurity. 82% in Borno State increase. This pattern was also repeated in other strongholds of the All Progressive Congress states. One begins to ask if insecurity is conducive to higher voter turnouts and security is antithetical to high voter turnout. It is further curious that the People's Democratic Party's margin of victory in states outside the Southeast and South-South were extremely slim across board. That again is a statistical impossibility. The fact is that when you calmly look at the numbers declared by the Independent National Electoral Commission as results of the February 23, 2019 elections, they do not add up at all. Let me say that I'm not speaking as a member of the People's Democratic Party. I am speaking as a Nigerian when I say that the electoral fraud perpetrated by the Buhari administration this past Saturday cannot produce a government of the people for the simple reason that it does not reflect the will of the Nigerian people. My dear Nigerians, it is for this reason that I, Atiku Abubakar, reject the results declared by the Independent National Electoral Commission. Declare Muhammadu Buhari as duly returned by the majority of lawful votes. I am conferring with not just my party, but also with the Nigerian people on next steps, which will be revealed to the public shortly. For my fellow Nigerians who feel angry, disillusioned, and let down by the process, I appeal to you to remain calm and steadfast. Rome was not built in a day. We have the real figures. We have the real figures. We have the facts that were spoken so loudly on Saturday, February 23, 2019. As I have always said, this year is my three decades in Nigeria's struggle for democracy. But this is the worst election in those 30 years. And I told that to General Abdusalam 2 nights ago when he called me. I said, not even the military has conducted such a worst election. This is a long journey, but I'm confident of victory. All hope is not lost. Stay strong. Stay strong. By the grace of God, we shall triumph. Amen. And to the international investors and friends of Nigeria now pulling out of our country, can you imagine only yesterday by that May announcement, the stock market lost $85 billion? I urge you to be patient and keep faith with the Nigerian people. Your quarrel is not with the Nigerian people. Your quarrel is with those who stole their mandate. Please do not punish the people by divesting from Nigeria. My dear citizens, I thank you all. And may God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Amen.